Good evening, I'm Mike Hill, and welcome to our Sunday night international sports special. Well, this week we're at Olympic Park in Melbourne for the soccer clash between the North American champion, the New York Cosmos, and the Victorian State side. Well, as you join us, the New York Cosmos are about to board their bus at the hotel to make their way to the ground, and let's now cross to our pre-match commentator, Laurie Schwab.
Thanks, Mike. We're on the Cosmos bus on the way to the game, and I'm talking now to Johan Neeskens. Johan, you scored two goals against Victoria last time. What do you remember about the game?
Well, I thought it was a very good game. Both teams played very well, and it was one of our last games on the whole tour. Now this game is more or less the beginning of our tour. So, but I hope it's going to be the same result and the same good game that it was 3 years before.
Your second goal was a winning goal, so Victoria was well in the game.
Yeah, and I think it was only a couple of minutes to play, and they tied the game 2-2, and then there was a corner kick from us. They could not clear it well, and I could score the goal by a half bicycle kick. It was a little bit of lucky, but in soccer you need luck too.
What's the general state of fitness of the players? What was your last game? How long ago?
Well, we played our last game last Saturday in LA, in Los Angeles. We played against the team, the champion of Mexico. The name was America. Mm-hmm. And we lost by 1-0. They scored with a penalty kick. And but we had a couple of good chances, and we didn't score them, so we lost that game 1-0. It was not that bad result. It was, it deserves better.
Everybody fit?
Yeah, I think everybody is fit, and it's up to the coach who he wants to play.
Vladislav Bogicevic, you arrived late. When did you actually arrive to join the Cosmos?
I don't arrive late. I come to the time. I'm here for the game, and I'm not come late.
You came direct from Belgrade, is that right?
No, I come direct for the plane. Yes, I come from Yugoslavia, right.
And are you playing today?
I don't know. I don't know. We have a game today or not? I don't know. We don't know who's going to play, and I don't know either.
He's keeping a secret until just before.
Well, probably, you know, he wants to give the lineup, you know, before the game. Now it's almost 2 hours before the game, and probably he doesn't know yet what kind of lineup he's going to put today, and he probably has some kind of new idea, probably. That's what I think.
You're right. This is your fourth visit, is that right, to Australia?
Seventh. I was a long time ago, maybe 12 years ago with Red Star, and several times. This is my second time with the Cosmos, and I hope we're gonna come maybe next year or 2 years. We like to come here. I think this is in a great country for the soccer and a progressive country, and I think, you know, every time when we come here we have a good game and people enjoy it. We have a good crowd in Sydney last year, 44,000. We have a good game here in Melbourne, and I don't see no any reason to, you know, Cosmos just come here every second year. I think it's much better for the Australian and the New York Cosmos to have every year a game.
Well, you're certainly popular here, so good luck for the game.
Thank you. We are very popular everywhere, not only here, but like my teammates say, you know, we come here to show something what we know is from United States, and I think you know, the people who come today, and I hope it's gonna be, you know, 25,000-30,000 people. We have a good weather and sun, you know, the people are gonna really enjoy it. That's more important than anything else. Cool.
So our thanks there to Laurie Schwab with the New York Cosmos. Let's now cross to the Victorian coach, which is also on its way to the ground, and there our commentator and the Victorian coach for the day, Tim White.
That's Tim White with the commentary team on the Victorian bus, and also of course with the Victorian team. Looking forward very much to the game, and I'm sure we'll get a good result today against the Cosmos. I'd like now to introduce you to the captain of the Victorian team today, John Gardner. He's playing his last representative game for Victoria after 22 appearances for the state side. John, how do you feel about today's game?
I'm looking forward to it very much. I mean, I'm a bit sorry that this will be my last game, but I feel I've survived maybe 10 years at international soccer, and I'm just going to step aside and let some young fellas take over. Maybe get involved in the coaching.
And the game against Cosmos, do you think this is a good one to bow out on?
Oh, tremendous. I mean, they're what I call a travelling circus. I mean, they've got big names, great entertainers, they'll throw the crowd. We can only do our best, and hopefully we will do quite well.
And that's the Victorian captain, John Garner. There are his views on today. I'd like now to introduce a couple of players who are who've played all their football in Melbourne, both Melbourne lads. I purposely introduced those because we very often hear a lot about imports and whether there's any local talent coming through the ranks. Firstly, goalkeeper today, Jeff Oliver. Looking forward to it, Jeff.
Very much so, yeah. A wee bit nervous, but hopefully everything will turn out fine. I'm hoping, anyway.
And how many times have you played for Victoria, Jeff?
This will be my second game. I played against Hungary earlier in the year. I missed the Watford game through dispute with the club, but that's about all, really. Just the two games at the moment.
And Canalia will be bearing down on you today. Does that worry you?
Well, it doesn't matter what league of soccer you play. You've got to save the ball. So, you know, it's fourth division or it's third division or international level, they all shoot at goal. So you just got to try and keep the ball at the net the best you can.
Victorian goalkeeper, Jeff Oliver. And sitting next to Jeff is his teammate from Heidelberg United and another local product, Charlie Ankers. How do you feel, Charlie?
A bit nervous, but I think I'll get used to it and really put in 100%.
So our thanks there to Tim White. Well, the fans are coming in through Olympic Park. The turnstiles have been busy now for the last hour or so. But now join me and our cameras as we see the arrival of the two teams.
Seven of this team, named by coach Professor Mazai, were in the Cosmos team that won the North American Championship by beating Seattle 1-0 thanks to a Canalia goal at San Diego in the American Super Bowl last month. Coming in for this game, young American stars Darryl G and Ian Hardkamp, and plus international stars Johan Naiskins and Franz Beckenbauer. Well, one player of interest to Australian fans will be Romero. Scorer of six goals last season, he came to prominence in the 1979 World Youth Cup in Japan when he was voted runner-up to the best player, Diego Maradona. Since then, he's gone on to represent Paraguay at full international level. Victorian coach Tim White names this Victorian side, which shows four players making their state debut. Canel, Ilioski, Melia and Paul Lewis get their first caps. For captain John Gardner, this will be his 21st and final state appearance. He made his debut back in 1973. He's had a slight injury recently and has had pain-killing needles to play in today's match. Top goal scorer in the State League in 1982 is Paul Lewis of Champions Green Gully Ajax. He's found the net 23 times and he'll be looking to open his state account in this his state debut. So our referee today, Mr. Stuart Mellins from Melbourne, a FIFA official, gets us underway with the New York Cosmos in the all-white outfit, and they're kicking from right to left in the first half with the assistance of quite a stiff breeze. They come up against the Victorian state side in the dark blue shirts, a state side, in fact, who's got an impressive record against visiting sides. And there's the first free kick of the afternoon for that heavy challenge on the Cosmos skipper, Giorgio Canalia. Already, trainer being called on. This is Victoria's tactics in the first 15 minutes. They intend to hit the Cosmos hard, not give them a chance to settle. And already Stuart Mellins reaching for the yellow card. And that's the first booking, and that comes within the first minute. And the player caught was Stuart Canel. So a sensational opening, yellow card, in the first 30 seconds to Stuart Canel. So what a way to mark your state debut. Cosmos with the free kick. This is Beckenbauer. It's Darryl G, one of the American youngsters. Certainly has had a good season. And now Romero. Canalia. Bogijevic there, robbed out of it by Ken Murphy. And the first touch of the afternoon there for the Victorian keeper, Jeff Oliver. This is Charlie Yankos, today in the left-back position. He actually plays as the central stopper for his club Heidelberg. And again, Charlie Yankos. One just pushed through. This is John Gardner, and again back to keeper Jeff Oliver. We've had a lot of rain here in Melbourne in the last couple of days. The pitch itself looks in magnificent condition, but it's a bit soft and spongy on top. And players could be slipping and sliding in the opening minutes until they adjust to this surface. Now Ken Murphy. Away from that challenge from Mayskins. Still Murphy. And the offside flag up. And Paul Lewis was the player caught. So the free kick quickly taken. Bogijevic. Now Kinalia. Bogijevic. Beckenbauer. And this is Kapp. Cabanas. Kapp again. And now Darryl G. Mayskins. Good run through there by Romero. And pulling that one back, but over the byline. And a goal kick to Victoria. So Victoria being able to bring it out of defence. This is their skipper, John Gardner. Charlie Yankos. Brogan. Good run through there by Jimmy Campbell and a good tackle from Jeff Gergen. Now Davis playing Beckenbauer in trouble. And now Mayskins. Darryl G. And Beckenbauer. Familiar swerving ball, but intercepted that time. Now Ilioski. Victoria pushing forward. Ilioski chipping that one in. The player climbing there was Jim Campbell. Now Mayskins. Cabanas was the player unable to keep that in. So for the New York Cosmos, there's their bench. Touring party of 19 players, and this in fact the first match of a tour that will take them to Korea and to Japan. Now Romero, Bogijevic, Kinalia, pushed that one a bit too far forward of Romero. Certainly a bright move that from the Cosmos. Stefan Mila. His state debut. 21 times he's played for the Polish Olympic team. At the moment, this is John Gardner. Now Campbell. This is Murphy. Turned in there by Brogan. First touch in the afternoon for Birkenheim. Changing the direction completely. This is Kapp. Kinalia. Starting to come deep. Yankos in there first for Victoria. Now Beckenbauer. Gijevic there giving that one away. This is Melia. Ilioski there clashing. Victoria looking for revenge in this match. These two teams met back in 1979. The Cosmos ran out winners that day by 3-2. Thanks to goals from Johan Niskins with 2 and Giorgio Canalia with 1. Now Durgan. Kapp. Davis. Romero. Hassled there by Ilioski. Jeff Durgan again. Cabanas. Bogijevic. Only arrived this morning from Yugoslavia, the last of the Cosmos to arrive. The rest of the team arrived here on Wednesday. It really is a surprise that He's in the team. Now, this is Paul Lewis, running at the defence as he loves to do. Lewis, a scorer of 23 goals this season for his club, Green Gully Ajax, champions of Victoria. And Beckenbauer there, another inch-perfect ball. That's his cap. Gijovic, Davis. Romero. Now, Davis. Screwed off the side of his foot. Canalia there, the player with his hands outstretched. So Rick Davis, who scored 9 goals in the North American Soccer League, but failed to find the back of the net in the season just completed. Appearances for Victoria. At the moment it's all the Cosmos coming forward. Bugijevic. Still Bugijevic. Cap. Bugijevic. Space ahead. Quickly closed down. Now Romero. Romero twisting that one. And there's the bar. It's the closest we've come to a goal in the first half after 8 minutes. And it was Romero who caused the problems. Really didn't seem to be too much on for him. Got the ball in just inside the area, made the angle, and Jeff Olver, completely beaten, thumps against the crossbar and away to safety. Now Ilioski as Victoria push forward. Peter Lewis. And the offside flag up. In fact, Paul Lewis, the player, caught. Birkenhire, there's the Victorian bench. The substitute there, the one in the middle, the tracksuit top, is Georgie Campbell from South Melbourne. Now, Neeskins. Rick Davis. Now Bugijevic. Cap on the overlap. Cabanas. And that took a touch there from Jeff Olver. Well, Cabanas really got a hold of that one. It was a good move forward from Victoria. There's Cabanas on the edge of the air, and he just turned and hit it first time. And a good fingertip save there from Jeff Olver. So the first corner of the afternoon for the New York Cosmos. Romero, the player, swinging it in deep. Jeff Durgan up there with the attackers, and now Neeskins, still Neeskins. Durgan, Canalia, and just wide. Well, the problems came for Victoria from the corner. Romero was the player that swung in across. Went to the far side of the box. Durgan got the shot in, Canalia the touch. And that wasn't too far wide. And now Ken Murphy. Gardner just pushing that one forward. Beckenbauer there away from Dave Brogan. In fact, Brogan judged to have been doing the fouling. Bugijevic, the midfield general for this Cosmos side, really does dictate play. Here he is yet again. Now Rick Davis. Neeskins on that far side, completely unmarked. First touch in. Cabanas. Wouldn't quite fall for a Cosmos boot. And the danger passes. Jeff Olver there slipping and sliding. And throw in to the New York Cosmos. It's So a good crowd here at Olympic Park this afternoon. Certainly at the moment, 13 minutes gone. A lot of interest in this match. Cosmos pushing the ball around with a lot of skill. And Romero. Well, the Cosmos are shooting on sight. Romero there with just a half chance. And he brought a fine save out of Jeff Olver. Very little backlift. That was goal bound. And Olver there touching that round the post. So now Romero with this corner, again deep, looking for Naiskins. Now Jeff Durgan, and just over the top. Well, goalkeeper Jeff Olver, at the moment, must think he's at the end of a shooting range. Again, it started with the corner that was knocked deep. And Naiskins there was the player that climbed to head it back. And then in comes Jeff Durgan. And look at that shot. It was just over the top. Now Ilioski. The Cosmos defence there moving up quickly. And Murphy was the player caught offside. Now Bogijevic. Carol G. And intercepted. And now Cabanas. Bogijevic. Trying to pick up Naiskins. Romero. Rick Davis. And a fine save again by Jeff Olver. Well, the Cosmos are not afraid to shoot. Whenever they get within 20 yards of the goal, they have a go. Here's Romero laying that back for Rick Davis. He didn't quite collect that the way he'd like to have done, but it took there a touch from Jeff Olver and the ball just passed that far post. Beckenbauer with the corner, back to Rick Davis. Chipping that one in, away by Charlie Yankos. Still the Victorian defence under pressure. And now Naiskins. Chipping that one in, Romero. And a good challenge there from John Gardner. So Romero, who's been involved in this first 16 minutes, has gone close a couple of times. Certainly proven to be a handful for this Victorian defence as he swings this corner in, and it's an own goal there from Stuart Cannell. A tragedy there for Victoria and for Stuart Cannell in his first appearance for the state. It's an own goal. Well, it started with this corner from Romero. Jeff Olver comes out, he's got it covered, he's not being challenged. It comes off the head of Cannell into the back of the net, and 16 minutes gone. We have a 1-0 scoreline. This is how it happened. And what a tragedy for Victoria. So there's the scoreline, 17 minutes. New York Cosmos 1, Victoria 0. And the Cosmos go ahead through an own goal. So now Victoria, with their backs against the wall, trailing by a goal. And now pushing back. Into the side netting, but the offside flag was up anyway. So Paul Lewis thought he was on for something there. It was clearly offside. Beckenbauer stops running. He still manages to put it past the goal, but it wouldn't have counted anyway. Now Cabanas away from that challenge from Melia. Those two played in the Paraguayan youth side, 1979. Both joined the Cosmos together. In fact, the time they joined the Cosmos, it was quite a surprise. They were two of the hottest young properties in world soccer. Now Rick Davis. Cosmos again pushing forward. Now Cap. Davis again, back to Cap. Now Bogijevic. Quickly closed down. Peter Lewis was the player that came away. And still Lewis. And they're dispossessed by Beckenbauer, but it might fall now for Brogan. And the shot was wide. Well, some adventurous stuff there from Peter Lewis, the right back. He just run from well inside his own half. He picks up Dave Brogan. And Brogan there tries a first-time shot, and that was wide. So we've had 19 minutes, and now let's join Laurie Schwab talking to the Victorian coach, Tim White.
Tim, what a blow. Off the head of Stuart Cannell, what happened?
Oh, it's an absolute tragedy. Jeff Oliver was coming behind him, and he was going to take the ball quite comfortably, and I think that he heard Jeff Oliver's call, and there was a little bit of hesitancy, and unfortunately for Stuart, it went in. But realistically, I think referee Stuart Mellins put Stuart Cannell under an awful lot of pressure by booking him in the first 30 seconds. The boy is obviously anxious. He made a tackle in the middle of the field. He could have spoken about it, but to give him a yellow card in the first 30 seconds has put the boy in an enormous amount of pressure, completely unnecessary.
Well, Phil, one can feel sorry for Stuart Cannell. It really was a harsh decision in 30 seconds, and then, of course, that own goal. But at the moment, the Victorian defence again under pressure. Now, Kinalia, that one charged down by Stuart Cannell, very much involved in the play in this first half. Now, Ilioski. Now, Mila. And again, the Cosmos defence moving up quickly. They're playing this offside trap to perfection. Mike Gort, the linesman, right in line with play. Now Beckenbauer. Bogijevic. Kinalia. Cosmos love playing this possession football. They're just pushing the ball around and making the task for the Victorians to get hold of this ball very difficult. Daryl G, Beckenbauer, Rick Davis, played in trouble there by Niskins, but got out of it nicely. And now Daryl G. Still G. And still Daryl G. Well, in the end, the ball run away from him, but certainly a good enterprising run there from the youngster. Just 20 years old. Daryl G there brought down. Free kick to the Cosmos just inside there, half of the field. And referee Stuart Mellins will have it taken in the correct spot. Now Beckenbauer. This is Cap. Oh, good run by Romero. Stop there by Peter Lewis, and in fact the ball must have taken its final touch from Romero because a goal kick's been given. So just over the halfway mark in this first half, Victoria trailing by a goal to nil, but of course remembering that they're facing quite a stiff breeze in this first half. It's a breeze that they'll have at their backs in the second half. But again, the defence playing themselves into trouble. This is Gardner, chipping that right across to keeper Jeff Oliver, not too far ahead of Cabanas. So Jeff Oliver, who's had a fine season here in Australia with the Heidelberg club. Finalist in the Phillips Cup and finishing up fourth in the PSL table. Now Franz Beckenbauer. Davis. G. Gajevic. Still players slipping and sliding on this surface. Cabanas. Niskins. Davis. Cosmos quite content to keep possession. Now Daryl G. was here last year with the American side for the World Youth Championships. Swinging that one in away by Canell. Picked up by Bugijevic. Now Cap. Cabanas. And dispossessed there. Victoria having no players push forward. Being forced back into the middle of the park. When they do break a Cosmos move down, there's nobody forward to take advantage. Now this is Peter Lewis. And a long one there for Paul Lewis to chase. Lewis, the top goal scorer in Victoria. And a good challenge there from Jeff Durgan. And now what is the referee given? Victorian players appealing for a penalty. Let's have a look at that incident. Durgan and Paul Lewis, the players clashing. Lewis there gets into the box and trips over Jeff Durgan's leg, and a free kick is given, just right on the edge of the penalty area. So one wonders what Victoria will have worked out from these free kick situations. So one's chipped in and away by Cosmos as far as Ilioski, going round the defence. Some good action there. The Cosmos coming away through Romero. Now Kinalia. And a good run through from Johan Niskins. Kinalia again. Beckenbauer finding an acre of space in the middle of the park. Now Romero. Beckenbauer. Lovely touch on Romero. That was Cabanas trying to get that one across. Gijevic. Now Rick Davis. Romero. Davis. Intercepted there by Melia. And now Jimmy Campbell. The Victorians again dispossessed. Cosmos quickly into the tackle. Cabanas. Canalia. Away there by Peter Lewis. Two Lewises in the Victorian side, neither of them brothers. Well, not to each other anyway. And at the moment, this is Ken Murphy. Getting that one in, much too close to the keeper. Bugijevic, Romero, now Beckenbauer, Bugijevic, Cap was the player that slipped, recovered quickly. Cosmos quite happy to push this around, probing for openings. Lovely skills from Cabanas, and that really delighted this Victorian crowd. Beckenbauer now back helping the defence. Now Romero. Bugijevic. Now Cap, Beckenbauer, Romero, trying to play that back for Canalia. Peter Lewis was the player in there first, but the Cosmos have got possession yet again. Now Canalia, Victorian defence playing themselves into trouble. Niskins and the offside flag up. In fact, Cabanas was the player caught offside, the referee allowing the advantage rule. Niskins. Again, Daryl G. Bugijevic. Cap. And nobody there for Cosmos on that far post, hooked away there by Charlie Yenkos. Now Rick Davis, Darryl G again. Darryl G. So now let's join Laurie Schwab. He's talking with Professor Mazai.
Professor Mazai, very happy you're leading. Romero is causing a lot of trouble to the Victorian defence.
No, I think that we are dominating the game what's concerned the possession of the ball, but the game of soccer means goals. We are not effective enough to capitalize the ball possession. We are playing nice and easy, but we need to score.
Well, certainly the Cosmos are the ones that are creating all the chances. But at the moment, they lead only by 1-0, and that goal coming from an own goal. Cap got a knock there after he'd played the ball. At the moment, it's back with Jeff Olver. Now Yenkos. So not much happening for the Victorians. Not many of the players running at the moment and making space. Now Mila. And now Jimmy Campbell. Still Campbell. And a good run through there from Dave Brogan. He's round the keeper. Chipping that one across. And nobody for Victoria could get on the end of it. But certainly a let off there for the New York Cosmos. They all stopped expecting an offside flag. And the flag stayed down. Possessed. Now Cabanas. And now Bogijevic. What a ball that was. Picking up Johan Niskins. Romero, first time in. Cabanas. Canalia. Victorians closing quickly down on Big Giorgio. Realise he's the danger man. 24 goals in the North American Soccer League this year. Now Beckenbauer, Romero, still Romero, pulling that one across, Canalia, and just wide. Well, a Victorian player must have got a touch. Professor Mazai is on his feet. With some lovely skills from Romero, and a good cross. Canalia there just failing to connect. It must have taken a touch from a Victorian player. So there again, Romero, a lovely through ball. Canalia just misses. It took a touch from a Victorian player and away for a corner. Now Mila. Dave Brogan. So the best chance of the match so far for Victoria. Chipping that one in, away by Jeff Durgan. Now Cabanas. Romero. And Canalia caught offside. The referee, Stuart Mellins, keeping a good control on this match. 32 minutes gone. Apprehensive looks on some of the Cosmos bench. They realise in the second half they're facing this very stiff breeze. One wonders if a one-goal advantage will be enough. But at the moment it's Victoria on the attack. And a good cross there from Dave Brogan. Now Ilioski. Taunting the Cosmos defence. Dispossessed there and Davis clears. Now Cabanas. Rick Davis again. That move breaks down. Now Mila. First time shot. And a testing one there for Birkemeyer. That ball was twisting and turning in the air. Well, this Stefan Mila tries that from a long way out. And that was dipping and swerving. And Birkemeyer there with his body behind the ball. Canalia and Peter Lewis with players clashing there off the ball. Referee Stuart Mellins having a quick word with Peter Lewis. Now Cabanas. knocked out of it there by John Gardner. And now David Brogan. Flag was already up. Freeways play on. Campbell was the player making the run through. Cosmos with the plenty of bodies back. And now they can break. This is Bogijevic. Naiskins. Darryl G. Bogijevic again. So much starts with him. Now Cabanas. Romero. Still Romero. Chipping that one in. Cabanas. And he just failed to connect. The two Paraguayan youngsters there combining well. So a few long faces on that Victorian bench. Just those substitutes hoping, I'm sure, they can get a run in the second half. And again, Cosmos can come forward. You seem to be finding so much space out there. Romero, Beckenbauer. Now Rick Davis going for a run forward. Canalia selling the dummy. Beckenbauer under pressure. And Cooley out of trouble. Now Romero. Gijovic. Davis. And now Cabanas. Knapp. On the overlap. Gijovic picks him up. Cabanas. Gijovic. Lovely touch on to Cabanas. Romero. The final ball needed to be a bit more accurate. But at the moment, Victoria again penned in their own half. Finding it difficult to penetrate this midfield in the defensive line of the Cosmos. Time shot, a fumble there by Jeff Olver, and Cabanas there trying to pick up the crumbs. So the free kick quickly taken by Canalia, the Victorian defence all at sixes and sevens, and Jeff Olver there thankfully grabs it at the second attempt. So this part of this mass crowd here at Olympic Park, certainly a good turnout to see the North American champions. This is Ken Murphy. Again, the move breaks down in the middle of the park and Cosmos can come forward. Now Cabanas trying to chip Jeff Olver. And just over the top. Well, Cabanas there saw the possibilities. He was on the edge of the penalty area. He saw that Jeff Olver was off his line and he tried the most delicate of chips. The goalkeeper struggling and that was just over the top. So delightful skills here from Cabanas. He looks up, sees the possibilities, Olver's off his line and backpedaling, and it's just over the top. Now Victoria pushing forward. This is Brogan. A one there for Jimmy Campbell to chase, but much too far ahead of the Heidelberg striker. Bogijevic slowing the pace down. Go ahead, Niskins, the king. Certainly Niskins has his fans here at Olympic Park in Melbourne. And now Darryl G. Back to keeper Jeff Olver and a quick throw out. Picking up Peter Lewis. Still Peter Lewis away from that challenge from Cabanas. John Gardner. He'll have to finish his Victorian career today with a win. Milan, lovely skills. The ball easily cut out there by Beckenbauer. Now Romero. Naiskins on that far side. Cosmos there giving the ball away rather easily. Naiskins trying to win it back. Yeah, Darryl G in there before Ken Murphy. So a throw in as we come up to half time. Just over a minute or so left. Not too much time for stoppages. And now this is Cap. Naiskins, Gijovic, threading that through to Cabanas. Now Kinalia, still Kinalia, stopped there by a weight of numbers. Now Campbell, Gijovic intercepts, this is Cap, Rick Davis, Beckenbauer, Gijovic, Beckenbauer, this looks dangerous, Romero, Cabanas, Beckenbauer. And in fact, Beckenbauer caught offside. But that really did look a promising move to Cosmos. They were cutting through the Victorian defence there like a knife through butter. Now Beckenbauer back in the sweeper's role. It's a big Jeff Durgan. Scored one goal in the North American Soccer League at Durban, and that was back on the 5th of September against San Diego. Cosmos won that day by 2-1. But at the moment it's Cabanas. Bogijevic. Now Canalia. Still Canalia. Cabanas. Looking for Romero. Naiskins. Charlie Yankos in there first, and Yankos there concedes the corner. So there, in fact, the corner won't be taken. Right on the stroke of 45 minutes, referee Stuart Mellins brings the first half to a close. The first half that saw the attacking from the Cosmos unable to turn that advantage into goals. They relied on an own goal from Stuart Cannell to give us a half-time score here at Olympic Park of the New York Cosmos 1, Victoria 0. So Victoria get us away at the start of the second half. They're now kicking from right to left. They trail by 1-0. Both sides during the half-time break have made substitutions. Georgie Campbell has come on for Victoria. He was wearing the number 13. There he is from South Melbourne Club. And he replaces Zoran Ilioski. And he's up against the number 2 for Cosmos, who's come on. That's Eskadarian. And a good cross there from Georgie Campbell. Victorian player could get on the end of it. So Eskadarian has come on instead of Darryl G, the young American star. And Eskadarian, of course, will be no stranger to this ground, playing back here in 1977 for Iran against Australia in the World Cup. So there's Eski, as he's known to his teammates. And now this is Franz Beckenbauer. So the Cosmos, who dominated possession in the first half, they were very rarely troubled at the back by this Victorian strike force. They really didn't turn their advantage into goals. Now this is Cap. Kinalia, a long way back to Birkemeyer. To the pleasure of the Victorian crowd. Now Jeff Durgan, who really had a strong game in the first half. Cabanas very much in the action in the first half with Romero, two players from this Cosmos side that seem to dominate proceedings. And this is Romero into action. Faced there by John Gardner. And well cut out there by Jeff Olver. This is Charlie Yankos. Georgie Campbell. Bill Campbell. And now Jankos. Campbell making the run. This is wee Georgie Campbell yet again. Good cross. The beat to Cap and also Dave Brogan. But Victoria, bright opening in this second half. They've got a throw on that far side. Still Victoria. Murphy charged down there by Gugicevic. Now Romero moves him out to Peter Lewis, getting that one across, right across the face of goal, away there by Escudarian. Now Mila, and a tremendous save there from Birkemeyer, and some applause there by coach Tim White. But certainly a bright move there from Victoria. And what a shot, and what a save there from Birkemeyer. So there's Tim White, the Victorian coach, as we now wait for this corner for Victoria.
Tim, a close shave that time, good shot by Miller. But really, what's the idea behind the substitution? George Campbell has come on.
Well, I think it gives us a little bit more attacking flair with Georgie's individualism. I just feel at this stage of the game that if we get people who go at these people and at the Cosmos players and take them on, I think we can get in behind them. And Georgie is good at that. And Zoran didn't really settle into the role that I gave him in the first half. So I think that Georgie will give us more attacking flair down the left. And of course, Kenny Murphy can still do it on the right for me.
Thanks, Tim.
So some words of wisdom there from coach Tim White, and he must be delighted with the Victorian performance in this first 4 minutes of the second half. They've certainly looked a lot sharper than they did in the first half. There's Giorgio Canalia, who's dropped deep now for Cosmos, brings the outer defence, but that move breaks down. And now Jimmy Campbell. Now Murphy. Still Murphy. Good challenge there from Cap. Murphy again getting that one in. And away by Jeff Durgan. Only as far as Mila. Now Georgie Campbell. Doing the job that he was brought on to do, but not even wee Georgie will catch that one. So this big crowd here at Olympic Park certainly getting behind the Victorian side in this second half. Now Romero. Now Bogicevic. And now Beckenbauer. Escudarian. Naiskins. Escudarian. That one across. Just a bit too far ahead of Canalia. Certainly a problem ball there for the Victorian defence. A throw in on that far side to Victoria. And Escudarian, which is reckoned to be one of the fastest fullbacks in the North American Soccer League, loves coming forward and overlapping. And that could prove to be a problem for the Victorian defence. So that's the view for goalkeeper Jeff Olver. He won't have been happy with that throw as now Cosmos can come forward. This is Canalia. Still Canalia. Cabanas. Straight into the arms of keeper Jeff Olver. And he's furious with his defence. Some explosive shooting there from Cabanas. Victoria pushing forward. This is Campbell. And the Cosmos there living dangerously. It was Paul Lewis, the player, going through. And the bounce of the ball there favouring the visitors. Now Bogicevic. Now Romero. Certainly a lot more pace in the game in the first 6 minutes of the second half. Victoria might have been a bit overawed at the beginning. Now Cabanas, now Canalia. Cabanas! It took a deflection, surely. No, says referee Stuart Mellins. Well, a golden opportunity there, firstly to Canalia and then to Cabanas. Cabanas there just flicks that one into Giorgio. Giorgio there completely miskicks it, then falls back to Cabanas, and his shot is wide. Now Bogijevic for the Cosmos. Skudarian. Canalia. Bogijevic. Playing Beckenbauer in trouble. That's the fastest Beckenbauer's had to move all afternoon. Now Romero. Tightly marked there by John Gardner. And the throw-in is given to Victoria. Romero not happy with that decision. And now this is Murphy. And now Georgie Campbell. Shot charged down there by Escudarian. Now Melia. Again testing Birkemeyer. Goalkeeper there watching that all the way through. And certainly this crowd here at Olympic Park now starting to rise to this Victorian side. Canalia there selling the dummy. Now Romero. Now Rick Davis. And that charge down there by Charlie Yankos. And away for a corner. And certainly this second half is starting at a cracking pace. So end-to-end action. The Cosmos have a corner. And Jeff Olver there organising his defence. Remembering, of course, the first goal was an own goal and it came from a corner. And then Bogijevic. Moscow two goals ahead, but really who got the final touch? The Cosmos players are congratulating Neskins. Let's see if we can pick it up on the replay. Bogijevic with the corner, Neskins there with the header, over the head of Olver, and John Gardner on the goal line is unable to clear. So Neskins there getting the touch, Jeff Olver off his line, and referee Stuart Mellins was ideally placed. And 9 minutes of the second half, the New York Cosmos 2, Victoria 0. So Johan Neskins scored twice when they played here in 1979. Gets his name on his score sheet. And Cosmos lead by 2-0. Now Jeff Durgan. Really now will be a test of character for the Victorian side. Brogan, the player, caught offside then. Now Jeff Durgan. Escudarian. Now Romero. Stuart Cannell across there. Yankos. That came off from Neskins. And a nice touch there from Johan Neskins as he turns around and checks that Charlie Yankos is okay. Peter Lewis. And a long ball forward. And Birkemeyer there well out of his goal. So some alert goalkeeping there from Birkemeyer. As the long ball was through there from Peter Lewis and picked up by Paul Lewis. But again, Victoria pushing forward. Murphy dispossessed. Bogijevic being forced back. And back there to the safety of keeper Birkemeyer. Then now Jimmy Campbell for Victoria. And now this is Paul Lewis and he's onside. Still Paul Lewis. Tremendous save there from Birkemeyer. He had Jimmy Campbell with him. And now this is George Campbell. John Gardner trying to chip the keeper. But what a let off there for the New York Cosmos. Surely Paul Lewis should have done better. Birkemeyer spreads himself well. And Paul Lewis there failing to pick up Jimmy Campbell with him. Now Bogijevic. Professor Mazai, the Cosmos coach, off the dugout, shouting instructions to his players. They're living rather dangerously at the back at the moment. But this is Rick Davis, headed on there by Romero. Now Canalia, Cabanas charged down by John Gardner. Now this is Peter Lewis. Too many Cosmos white shirts back on that occasion. Now Romero, Bogicevic, Beckenbauer, Rick Davis, Bogicevic, Canalia. Canalia, 3-0. Giorgio doesn't miss them. There's Giorgio Canalia, the top goal scorer in the North American Soccer League. But what a lovely move from the Cosmos. Bogicevic, he picked up Giorgio Canalia. From there, he's absolutely deadly. So 13 minutes gone in the second half. This is it from behind the goal. Canalia there gives Jeff Olver no chance. And it gives us now this scoreline of the New York Cosmos 3, Victoria 0. So Giorgio Canalia, as he does so often, has got his name on the score sheet. And in fact, that goal came in when Victoria were having their best spell at attacking. So Professor Mazai there going to make another substitution. Sorinho, the Portuguese star, is the player that's stripping to come on. Problems there between Romero and Peter Lewis. Quickly stopped there by referee Stuart Mellins, who lets play continue. Now Eskadarian, Bogicevic. And a bad ball there, but it fell nicely in the end for Jeff Durgan. Now Romero, Bogicevic, and now Niskins behind the defence, chipping that one across, away by Stuart Cannell, and now with Charlie Yankos. And Yankos there, a long ball forward, which still hasn't gone out. They're failing to pick up Jimmy Campbell with him. Now Bogicevic. Professor Mazai, the Cosmos coach, off the dugout, shouting instructions to his players. They're living rather dangerously at the back at the moment. But this is Rick Davis, headed on there by Romero. Now Canalia, Cabanas charged down by John Gardner. Now this is Peter Lewis. Too many Cosmos white shirts back on that occasion. Now Romero, Bogicevic, Beckenbauer, Rick Davis, Bogicevic, Canalia. Canalia, 3-0. Giorgio doesn't miss them. There's Giorgio Canalia, the top goal scorer in the North American Soccer League. But what a lovely move from the Cosmos. Bogicevic, he picks up Giorgio Canalia. From there, he's absolutely deadly. So 13 minutes gone in the second half. This is it from behind the goal. Canalia there gives Jeff Olver no chance. And it gives us now this scoreline of the New York Cosmos 3, Victoria 0. So Giorgio Canalia, as he does so often, has got his name on the score sheet. And in fact, that goal came in when Victoria were having their best spell at attacking. So Professor Mazai there going to make another substitution. So Coutinho, the Portuguese star, is the player that's stripping to come on. Problems there between Romero and Peter Lewis. Quickly stopped there by referee Stuart Mellins, who lets play continue. Now Eskedarian, Bugijevic. And a bad ball there, but it fell nicely in the end for Jeff Durgan. Now Romero. Bugijevic. And now Niskins behind the defence, chipping that one across. Away by Stuart Cannell. And now with Charlie Jankos. And Jankos there. A long ball forward, which still hasn't gone out of play. And Berkemar there playing as an extra defender. And that was a terrible ball from the keeper. And the Cosmos goal is completely unmarked. But Franz Beckenbauer, cool under pressure, plays his side out of trouble. I think people must be wondering what Berkemar was doing. Now Cabanas, Beckenbauer, Bugijevic, looks like the player who will be coming off. Remembering, of course, he only arrived this morning from Belgrade. Mila, Jimmy Campbell, this is Murphy, arms outstretched, not too much on for him. Now Peter Lewis, a heavy challenge there from Jeff Durgan, as he picks Dave Brogan up, taps him on the head, makes sure he's okay, and now the Cosmos can make their substitution. Bugijevic is the player coming off. And Suninho, the Portuguese star, is the player coming off. So Bugijevic there getting a tremendous round of applause from their fans here at Olympic Park. Suninho, the player going on, the speedy winger from Portugal. Signed from Oporto in Portugal back in 1978. At the moment, Victoria with the free kick, Cosmos with a five-man wall. And John Gardner, Georgie Campbell. John Gardner there to Campbell, trying to get around the back of the defence and into the side netting. In fact, the run eventually was made by Ken Murphy. But at the moment, Cosmos there on the break. And Cabanas caught offside. Now Victoria preparing to make a substitution. Carl Gilder, the player coming on. Score of one goal for George Cross, his club this year in the Victorian League. He's made eight appearances for Victoria before today. Still waiting to get on. Now Stuart Cannell. Lewis. This is Dave Brogan, and he'll be the player that'll be coming off. A header there, Paul Lewis, and again safely fielded by keeper Berkemeyer. So the Cosmos there just pushing the ball out of play so that Johan Niskins, who took a knock in that last challenge, can get some treatment. And this will give Victoria the chance to make their substitution. So Dave Brogan has made one appearance for Victoria before today. Is the player coming off. He scored 18 goals this season for his club, Croatia. And he also scored for Victoria in his only other appearance, a 2-1 loss to New Zealand. So he comes off, and Carl Gilder is the player coming on. So Johan Niskins still receiving treatment. Arnold Trachtenberg, the trainer with the New York Cosmos on this trip. So after all of that, we're back in the action, a throw to Victoria. Chipping that one in, Campbell trying to get on the end of it, and just a bit too far ahead. So Escudarian for the Cosmos. Kinalia, Escudarian. Now Paul Lewis. This is Peter Lewis going for a run from fullback. Swinging that one back, easily cut out there by Rick Davis and tied it up by Beckenbauer. Now Romero. So Nino, his first touch, since coming on as a substitute, promptly gives the ball away. Now Jimmy Campbell. John Gardner chipping that one forward. Beckenbauer is the player under pressure. Now Georgie Campbell. So Nino there, the player chasing back. The New York Cosmos preparing to make another substitution. Robert Yerushi, the Canadian international, will be the player coming on. But at the moment, Victoria with the throw from Charlie Yankos. Away there by Jeff Durgan. Melia. And that screwed off the side of his foot and away for a goal kick. So Johan Niskin's the player that's going to come off for the Cosmos. As soon as they can attract the attention of referee Stuart Mellins. He took a knock a couple of minutes ago, and I think Cosmos taking him off now purely as a precautionary measure. They lead by 3-0. And they really have got a long, arduous tour ahead. Now Rick Davis. This is Cap. Davis again. And now Naiskins. Could be his final touch of this match. Now Escudarian, away there by Cannell. And Jimmy Campbell back to his teammate in the Heidelberg club, Jeff Olver. Sorry, they're giving that ball away to Rick Davis. It's now back with Cap. Beckenbauer, Cap, now Romero, Naiskins, and now Escudarian with some space ahead. Sonino, past the defence, this is danger, Sonino, and Canalia has his shot cleared off the line by keeper Jeff Olver. Still the danger's not clear, now Rick Davis chipping, and just over the top. So now the Cosmos can make their substitution. Yerushi, the Canadian international, is the player coming on. As they do that, we'll watch this chip again from Rick Davis, just over the bar. In fact, a touch there from keeper Jeff Olver. So Naiskins, the player off, there he goes back to the dugout. Yerushi, the player on. And now Georgie Campbell for Victoria. Mila. Paul Lewis. Victoria, they're losing the momentum of the attack. And now Ken Murphy. Murphy. Well, ambitious. It wasn't too far wide and high. That's the view from our camera from behind the goal. Escudarian, and back to keeper Birkemeyer. And our friends Beckenbauer. Just over the halfway point of this second half. New York Cosmos 3, Victoria 0. Now Georgie Campbell. Jimmy Campbell. Flag up on the far side, the referee weighs play on, and now Yerushi. Sonino. So as this attack goes on, let's now cross to Laurie Schwab, talking, I would think, to a very delighted Professor Mazai.
Professor, you're 3-0 ahead now, but only after Victoria's best attacks.
I didn't understand you.
I say Victoria attacked very well for a while before you went ahead 3-0. You seemed a bit upset by your defence.
Oh, yes, a little bit. I'm a perfectionist.
I like to see every play decide as a goal. Do you know what I mean? And that's the reason, because I never gonna be satisfied. For me, I would like to see a perfect game. And I know that there are no things like a perfect game. But we are doing well. It's okay.
So delighted, Professor Mazzai there. As Jimmy Campbell's bundled down, and that's a penalty. So Urushi, the player who came on as a substitute, gives away the penalty when he bundled Jimmy Campbell in the back. Let's look at it again. I think there's very little doubt on this. There's Campbell, Urushi there, just rushing in the back of him. And that's got to be a penalty. And that's exactly what referee Stuart Mullins has given. So an ideal chance now for Victoria to get onto the score sheet. We've had 25 minutes of the second half. Ken Murphy to take the penalty and scores. So Victoria pull one back. Applause there from coach Tim White. And Ken Murphy places it past Birkemeyer with the greatest of ease. The New York Cosmos 3, Victoria 1, and that's how you take a penalty. Tim White.
You had some very promising attacks early on in this half. The goalkeeper had to come out a few times. You've got a goal out of it, but you're 3-1 down.
Yeah, it's a strange thing, Larry. Probably our best penalty game was the first quarter of an hour after the half-time whistle, and we conceded two goals. One, I don't really know what happened with the one that was hooked off the line. Don't really know what happened with the one that was hooked off the line, but the linesman spotted it was just over. And, of course, Canaglia put one away. That was a very nice move. We had a couple of breaks. We didn't quite put them off, but we're still in this game now. This goal will lift the lads.
Now Rick Davis. Sonino. Still Sonino. Cabanas. Rick Davis. Canaglia. Cabanas. Just one pass too many there from the Cosmos. Now Beckenbauer. Romero on that far side, faced there by Peter Lewis. Good run there from Cap. Canaglia unable to pick up the crumbs. Urushi. Turning away nicely there from Paul Lewis. Sonino. Cabanas. Sonino. Still Victoria trying to make a substitution. They're going to bring on Doug Brown, striker from Preston. Certainly could cause problems for this Cosmos defence. He loves running at defenders. Sonino. Rick Davis. Beckenbauer. Romero.
Turn it behind your tight!
Sonino. Escudarian. Canaglia at the far post. That's where he's aiming for. Put away there by Peter Lewis. Handball there against Cap. Referee Stuart Mullins will have a quick word at the fullback. There it is, Victoria away there, and Cap seeing the danger, a blatant handball. And while we were watching that, Victoria have made their substitution. Melier is the player that's come off, and Doug Brown from Preston is the player that's come on. One thing can be sure, Doug won't take a backward step. And Doug Brown there, nearly into the action. Urushi there, back to Birkemeyer. So Doug Brown, who scored 11 goals in the Phillips League this year, knows he's got just over 10 minutes left to get his name on the score sheet and help his team back into this match. They trail by 3-1. Now Cabanas. Ricky Davis. show too much of that to Peter Lewis. And now Victoria can break. Still Peter Lewis threading that one through for Gilder to chase. But Birkemeyer out there first. Now Cap, Beckenbauer. Escudarian with some space ahead. Romero. Davis. Escudarian. Urushi. Now Rick Davis. Cosmos quite happy to play possession football. Leading by 3-1. And just 10 minutes left. Now Escudarian. Now Romero. And wide. Yankos, and now Doug Brown with his first touch since coming on as substitute, and he scored! Doug Brown with his first touch since coming on as a substitute, gives Victoria some hope, but I think you have to put that down to a goalkeeping error. 36 minutes of the second half, disaster there for Birkemeyer. But Doug Brown here takes this one up to the edge of the penalty area. And Birkemeyer there lets that slip through his hands over the line. And certainly Victoria back in this game. There was the shot. And Birkemeyer will be sick when he watches that. So 36 minutes gone. Doug Brown gets his name on the score sheet. And we've got a scoreline of Cosmos 3, Victoria 2. That's how the teams finished up when they met here in 1979. One wonders now if history will repeat itself. Rick Davis, Cabanas now, Beckenbauer, all off the top of the bar. Franz Beckenbauer so close. And you can see how close that thumps against the top of the bar and away to safety. Franz Beckenbauer. I'm sure this big crowd here in Olympic Park would be delighted to see him get his name on the score sheet. And you don't really get much closer. Now Cabanas. Georgie Campbell there helping his defence. Minutes ticking away for Victoria. Just over 6 minutes. So Tim Rick Davis. Now Durgan. Cabanas. Now Escudarian. Sohinho. Still Sininho, Romero, and just over the top. Cosmos so close there to making it goal number four. It really was a good move. Sininho was involved. He laid it back for Romero, and his shot was well over the top. So we've now got just over 6 minutes left, and let's now cross to... Let's cross to Laurie Schwab, who's talking to the Victorian coach, Tim White.
Tim, you brought on Doug Brown as an extra man up front. It really worked for you.
Yeah, well, we were losing 3-1, and I thought that we could sacrifice a midfield player and go looking for another goal. And Dougie done what he's good at, didn't he? He turns and he had a shot at goal. So we're back in the game 3-2, and it's very much alive in the last few minutes.
So Tim White still with hope. He'll know there's just 5 minutes left. The Cosmos still lead by 3-2. And at the moment, it's the Cosmos coming forward. This is Escudarian. Now Romero. Still Romero. And still Romero, stopped there by that tackle from Charlie Yankos. And now Ken Murphy. So the Cosmos coach, that's Professor Mazar, he's up on his feet. Worrying times for a coach. Seen his team's lead for 3-0, now whittled down to 3-2. At the moment, Victoria with a free kick to be taken by John Gardner. Doug Brown, and Brown there brought down by Yerushi. A free kick on that far side to Victoria. John Gardner, player lining up to swing this free kick in. Victoria throwing everybody forward. Decides to touch it off. Right across the face of goal. Now Doug Brown, shot charged down by Beckenbauer. And in fact now Cosmos can break. And now here's Suninho. Cabanas is the player with him. This is Cabanas. And it needed a better ball than that. In fact it hit Charlie Yankos. So what a break that was, with Victoria doing the pressing. And they were nearly caught out at the back. Now Yerushi, Romero, Cabanas, Escudarian, now Cabanas, Suninho, still Suninho, swinging that one across, Fennell just knocking that up in the air, Jeff Olver under pressure and takes it there at the second attempt. Problems there for Victoria. And Jeff Olver, only too pleased to grab that at the second attempt. So Tim White and Bobby McLaughlin, the Victorian coach and assistant coach, trying to urge their players on to one final effort, but at the moment it's the Cosmos going forward. This is Rick Davis. Suninho. Lining up to rifle that, decides against it, pushes that one across. Now Romero, George Campbell away for Victoria. And now Ken Murphy. An error there by Peter Lewis, stops that attack. Referee Stuart Mellin starts to check his watch. There's still a minute and a half to go on ours. Now this is Cap. Yerushi. And now Franz Beckenbauer. Now Escudarian. Durgan. Beckenbauer. Cosmos love forming these little triangles. Jeff Durgan. And that all breaks down. Now Stuart Cannell. And that one cut out by Cap. And another good challenge from the youngster. Jeff Durgan. Leaves it for Franz Beckenbauer. And now Rick Davis. That might break for Cabanas. In fact, John Gardner there tidying up for Victoria. Yerushi. Safety first tactics. Not to the liking of the Victorian crowd. But we're into the final minute. The New York Cosmos 3, Victoria 2. The Cosmos know now they're less than 60 seconds away from starting their world tour with a win here in Australia. The next stop after this is Korea, then it's on to Japan. Now Ken Murphy. Right across, just needed a touch, and nobody was able to get on the end of it for Victoria. So part of this mass crowd here at Olympic Park, some starting to make their way home. On our watch now, it's just a matter of seconds. There wouldn't be too much stoppage time to be added. And now Franz Beckenbauer bringing it out of defence for the Cosmos, over the halfway line. Picking up Jeff Durgan. And now Cabanas, it wouldn't quite fall for him. And Cabanas there doing some pushing and shoving. And the free kick to Victoria. So on our watch now, we're playing stoppage time. We've had 30 seconds of that. And Jeff Olver will just about have enough time to pump this one forward. Referee Stuart Mullins has checked his watch. Urushi. Rick Davis still full of running for the Cosmos. One of the exciting American youngsters. He's now left flattened on the far side of the field, and there, in fact, is the final whistle. And we have a repeat scoreline of 1979. That game was played on the 21st of October. And as then and as now, the New York Cosmos 3, Victoria 2. Certainly this big crowd has been entertained. It really has been a privilege for them and for all of us, in fact, to see Franz Beckenbauer in action at the start of his farewell tour, one of the world's greatest superstars. And Beckenbauer having to make a run from the ground before he's surrounded by all the youngsters, waves to the crowd in salute, and the crowd here at Olympic Park standing to applaud a great champion from the park. So what an exciting afternoon here at Olympic Park. The first goal coming as an own goal, in fact, from Stuart Connell. That gave the Cosmos a half-time scoreline of 1-0. Neeskens and Canalia put them 3-0 up in 13 minutes of the second half. And then a fight back from Melbourne with Ken Murphy from the penalty spot after 25 minutes. And then Doug Brown, who came on and scored with his first touch after 36 minutes. So that was all of the scoring. A final scoreline, a Victoria 2, the New York Cosmos 3. So an exciting finish there to the New York Cosmos Victoria game. And with me now, Laurie Schwab. Laurie, quite an interesting match.
A great finish, Mike. I thought they might have got another goal towards the end, but Tim White, the coach, did the right thing. He brought on two more forwards towards the end. Doug Brown, of course, he scored the goal. George Campbell made a big difference when he came on. But the first half, Vladislav Bogicevic, he really impressed me. It was amazing. I mean, the guy came off the plane this morning. He played in Europe for Yugoslavia early in the week, but he came this morning, and what a display he put on until he got tired. But the man up front, Romero, he was dynamite, wasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely.
And when he was needed again towards the end of the match, again, it was he who sparked up the forward line. Unfortunately, he didn't get among the scorers, but I think without him, the others wouldn't have scored either.
The Victorian side seemed to start very slowly. Do you think there was a bit of nerves there?
Definitely, you know, a lot of nerves early. You could see some of the players were shadows of their former selves. I'm talking about shadows of the form they show in club games. I think Ilioski, playing his first game, he was a bit overawed by the situation. He came off. But towards the end of the first half, when Mila started firing, he had a few long-range shots at goal. I think the game started to change a little bit. And even just after half-time, Victoria probably had their best period. Unfortunately, it was during that period that Cosmos went ahead.
Well, I suppose we can't leave this game without saying something about Franz Beckenbauer. Age does not weary him, does it?
Oh, no, what a player. I don't know if you saw it, but during the second half, he actually lobbed a little ball over the head of Jimmy Campbell in the midfield to get it to the guy behind him. And he was doing that sort of thing all the game. Of course, he didn't really have much responsibility in the game. He wasn't really playing sweeper. He wasn't playing midfield. I mean, he was just picking up the ball where he wanted it. And he also had one shot at goal, came very close. And I suppose that would have been the icing on the cake had he scored a goal as well.
So there we are, Franz Beckenbauer starting his farewell tour, his farewell appearance to Australia. What an exciting evening. We thank you for joining us, and we hope you'll join us again next week for another Sunday Sports special. But a reminder to the soccer fans that you can collect World Soccer on Wednesday nights with Les Murray, and a complete roundup of international and local soccer action on Friday night's International Sports Magazine. On behalf of Laurie Schwab, I'm Mike Hill. Good night.